All right, hey, welcome back to Mechanical Pros. Today, I'm here with Braden, and we're gonna be doing some brazing and soft soldering. Braden, you ever done this before?
More than I want.
Okay, all right, good. I only do this for demo, and it's always terrible. So hopefully I'll be a good student for you.
We'll see if we can make a good brazer and soft solder out of you.
I'm not that hopeful. let's dig into it and show me how to do it.
Yeah, let's do it.
All right. We got this vise set up here. Perfect situation. This is what every job site's like. Just kidding.
Yeah, not necessarily, John. So a lot of times whenever you're brazing or soft soldering, you're in a tight position up above your head, down below. There's some pretty tricky ones.
Yeah, got a mirror in your mouth trying to break.
Yeah, it's not every day you get something this easy.
Yeah.
So.
So tell me about the tools we got going on.
Yeah.
Here.
So we got a torch right here. We call this a B torch. Okay. It's connected to a B tank. It's just 100% acetylene.
Okay.
And we got a striker. So striker.
And how's that different than oxygen acetylene?
So an oxygen acetylene, they're a little bit hotter. You're actually mixing oxygen with acetylene. Yeah. B bottle is quicker. The heat's not as condensed as with an oxyacetylene rig. Yeah.
Yeah, more refrigerant piping.
Yep.
Focused.
Yep.
All right. Striker, torch.
And then right here we have our sil-fos rod. So this is 15%. Sil-fos rod,
okay.
15% silver. This is what we typically use on refrigerant pipe, things like that.
Okay.
We'll get started here.
All right, let's do it.
So we'll crack this open a little bit. Whenever you crack this open, you want to just open it a little bit. Don't go all the way with it. And crack it up.
Getting the copper warmed up.
Yep, we're warming the copper up. One thing you want to pay attention to whenever you're doing this is you want to keep your heat where you want your sil-fos to go.
Okay.
So as you see, I'm holding it in the joint. I want this to travel down through the joint. Hit take there. Over on this side. That's it, take right there. You noticed whenever that copper starts to get kind of, we call it cherry red, whenever it starts to get red, that's whenever it's ready to take.
Mm-hmm.
And sil-fos melts at about 1200 degrees Fahrenheit.
Okay. When you strike your next torch, I want you to talk about what kind of flame you like to see in the
Let's do it. All
right.
So what we're looking for here is kind of a long blue flame.
Mm-hmm.
So I'll demonstrate that here. So you see right here, we got kind of yellow in there.
Yeah.
So that blue, that bright blue tip, right there, that's what you want. I'm gonna do one more and then I want you to do one. Okay. You notice whenever it got cherry red right there, it just pulled it right in. Yep. And a lot of people that I've seen, and I used to be guilty of it myself, will hold the heat kind of at the joint because that's ultimately where you're starting.
Mm-hmm.
If you do that, it'll take right there, but you want to have that heat back in in the coupling.
Mm-hmm.
And the reason you want to do that is because you always put your heat where you want your sil-fos or your solder to go.
You want that sil-fos to get sucked all the way up in there, all the way to the lip of that coupling.
Yep.
And to seal that completely. Huh?
Yep. Seal it completely, and it'll also make it a lot stronger.
Okay. A lot of times you see some really nasty brazes where you got drips and drops all over this and that.
Yeah.
Is that a function of it not being hot enough, or is that a function of too much sil-fos?
Could be both.
Okay.
If you see where it looks like bubble gum stuck on there,
yeah,
that's probably not hot enough, where it's not actually taken. It's just kind of balling up
mm-hmm.
on the joint or on the pipe. But If it's all dripping out, that's a, probably a case of too much,
okay,
too much sil-fos.
Tell me about how to get all the way around that thing, because you don't have to get it every single, it kind of sucks up automatically.
Yeah.
It's kind of physics and nature kind of.
Yeah, so I like to just watch it. And if you watch it and you're paying attention where that's going, and if you notice on this last one I did over here,
uh-huh,
I had it like this. I left about a quarter inch hanging off.
Uh-huh.
And a lot of times what you can do is get that heat on there and it'll actually, this will fall and wrap down into the seam.
Yeah. Okay.
So you want just a little bit coming out to start with. There you go.
That's right.
And get that nice bright blue flame out of it.
Like a train whistle.
Yep.
You good about that?
Yep. That looks good.
All right, we're gonna do this joint right here.
Yep. Remember, you want to hold your heat on the back side of that joint. You want to put your heat where you want your sil-fos to go. Get the bottom side a little bit more.
A little hot.
That's good. So now that it's cooled down some,
yeah,
we're gonna go ahead and prepare it to soft solder. So we want to clean this off, this carbon buildup that we made. So we'll take a pipe cleaner right here. We'll just wrap it around, get it all cleaned up here. Okay.
That's just something you get at any supply store.
Yeah. Lowe's, Home Depot, any supply store.
Sandpaper.
Yep. Yeah. So we actually got some sandpaper here, cleaning cloth.
Yep.
Just take that. Do that with it. Same thing down here.
But if you go to the supply counter, you call it cleaning cloth.
Yeah. So cleaning cloth.
Like an idiot. Yeah.
So now brings us to our paste.
Yeah.
So with soft soldering, you want to use this paste. It has flux in it and it just keeps everything clean whenever you're soft soldering.
Okay.
One of the differences between soft soldering and brazing with sil-fos is soft soldering, you have to have it super clean or the solder will not take.
Okay.
It has to be clean. So one of the things that I've always learned that it's always easier to do your take a little bit longer, do more prep on the front end whenever you're soft soldering. Get as clean as you can get it with that clean cloth, your pipe cleaner, whatever you have. But take this paste, we'll just put a little bit on here.
And what does that connection to the purge look like? You're running nitrogen through it.
Yeah.
How would you just run in, you got a hose connection? How do you connect that?
Yeah, so if you're doing say installing a split system and running refrigeration pipes through there, you typically connect your purge up to your unit, and then you would have, at the end of your piping, you'd have somewhere to let the nitrogen kind of seep out.
So whatever's going in's got to come out.
Yep. You want a kind of a steady flow of nitrogen going through there, through
Is
the whole system.
Is there a pressure it needs to be at to keep it flowing, or how do you, Can it flow up and down? Does it matter which direction you're flowing?
Doesn't matter which direction you're flowing. It just needs to be flowing.
Yeah.
So say if you have it going in the suction line, you want to make sure it's coming out the other end of the liquid line.
Okay.
So it's making a full loop around there. You don't want anywhere where there's just oxygen just sitting in there where it could cause carbon buildup inside the piping.
Okay.
And sometimes I've seen if you're doing, like, say, welding stainless steel, they make actual caps that go on the piping with an O-ring fitting on the inside.
Okay.
And you connect a purge setup to that, which is a tank similar to our B tank here, but it's just full of nitrogen instead of instead of acetylene.
Okay.
Alrighty. So we're fitted up now. Pretty much the same principle, soft soldering, John, as brazing. You want to hold your heat where you want your solder to go.
Okay.
Soft soldering though, you don't need as much heat as you do with brazing.
Okay.
You'll see that here in a minute. Soft solder melts at about 850 degrees, where sil-fos is about 1200. Same practice, hold the heat in the back of the joint where you want your solder to go. maybe I even got that a little bit too hot. And then once you know that you have solder in the gap, I like to go back over it with a cap. We'll get it warm here. Solder in there. Let it cool down just a little bit. And then kind of the same thing we were talking about with the sil-fos. Give about a quarter inch out. Cool down a little bit here. So.
So sil-fos, we're doing sil-fos on higher pressure piping.
Higher pressure.
Refrigerant piping, med gas piping.
Correct.
Anything over 200 PSI.
Roughly, yeah. Yeah.
So like 410A.
410A, yeah. Thing. Anything med gas, oxygen, that stuff's okay. All really high pressure.
And then soldering's more designed for low pressure.
Yeah, water, something that's on city water pressure, cold water, hot water applications, things like that.
Okay. Hydronic systems. Pretty much soldering.
Soft solder, yep.
Okay. All right, and then, so the sil-fos, we're doing 15% silver.
Yep, 15% silver.
And then what are we using for solder? What is the solder content?
Yeah, so it used to be a lead-based solder, but they have since found out that lead's not good for us.
People don't like lead.
With it being in potable water systems.
Yeah.
So it's got some silver in it, and it's just an alloy of soft metals that bonds to the copper and provides a good seal in there.
Okay. I feel like we did a decent job doing our sil-fos.
Yeah.
And then we got way too hot.
Really, honestly, truly should have had a different torch set up on that, something like a map gas, something handheld that's a lot lower temperature. The B-bottle, it works great for sil-fos joints. Soft solder, it just gets it way too hot, as you saw, and once you get it that hot, it makes that carbon. You get the carbon in the solder joint, it's over.
Okay. And then how do you clean up your mess?
The solder, it just scrapes off.
Okay.
So we can just literally peel it off. Okay. And it doesn't bond anything like this, so that's the good thing with that.
It's too dirty.
Yep.
Okay. I'm obviously not a professional. I don't do this every day. How long do you think it takes someone to become pretty good at this?
I'd say doing it repetitively, a couple months, you could get pretty good at it.
Okay.
If you're on a big commercial job and you're making 100 joint or 100 solders a day, you're gonna get pretty good at it pretty quick. You're gonna figure it out.
All right. It's so, all about where you put that heat.
It's where you put that heat.
And that sil-fos and that solder will follow that heat.
It will. All right. And how you prep with the solder.
Okay. All right. So, more prep, easier job.
Better outcome.
Well, there you go. Learned something new today. Screwed something up, but trying something new as well. And that's how we do it at Mechanical Pros. So hit that like, hit the subscribe. Thank you so much for the support, and we'll catch you next time.